it looks like they're going to send out the punting unit. Don't see this happening too often this season so far for the Bison. Number 80, Marcel Donoso. Out there for a rare Bison punt.
We haven't seen them where they really needed to punt that often, to be honest. At least not in the games we've been here for.
And this will be a delay of game going against the Bison. So fourth and six will become fourth and 11 again.
That'll be a 5-yard penalty. And we'll replay the fourth down.
First penalty of the game by the Bison.
The pace of the game really seems to have slowed down. I mean, we got off to a, you know, a really fast start out of the gate.
That punt is up.
Ooh, the ball is out, and the Bison have it. What a mistake there by the Vipers. Number 34 just couldn't secure it. Marquise Taylor.
In fact, he called, and I'll roll that back if you want, but it looked to me like he called for a fair catch.
Well, even if he calls for a fair catch, if he drops it, that's a fair ball. The Bison, fantastic job by that special teams unit to get down on top of it. And now they have a new set of downs well into the Viper territory.
Yeah, he called for the fair catch, dropped the ball, and here we go. First and 10 Vipers on an incredible break. And now we have no grounds upon which to question the punt.
That's right. First and 10 from the Vipers' 27-yard line. 7:21 left to go here in the first quarter. Harris with the snap, and Vipers are showing blitz. Harris throws it far side, over the head of his intended target, and actually in and out of the hands of the defender. Number 5, A.J. Dillett, was actually in the right spot, to make that catch.
A nice clean play by both players, both the receiver and the defender.
Carl Stewart, the intended target, unable to come up with that one. So second and 10, clock stops, 7:15 on the clock. Harris with couple of white jerseys in his face in that last throw might have had something to do with that. And the pitch out to Love, and white jerseys all over the place. He gets away from the first one, the second one, he's still moving forward on his feet. I thought he was at least going to make it back to the line of scrimmage, and there's that playmaking ability that he has. He just shrugged off three white jerseys before they were able to secure him.
Bring up second down and about 15 for the Bison.
They'll mark Love with a 3-yard loss. So second and 13 third and 13. And it looks like we'll have our first timeout of the ball game. And it will be the Vipers who decide to talk about it here on this defensive call. 6:33 left to go here in the first quarter. 1-point lead for the Bison. A muff punt by the Vipers set the Bison up in beautiful territory at the Vipers 27, and unfortunately they've just kind of stalled out right now. The last this offensive drive extending,
right,
started at 8.5 minutes left to go. So had an opportunity to keep things going, but it just seems to, like you said, Kevin, they're just coming out a little flat right now.
Yeah, I mean, that is an incredibly lucky break, you know, and you know, it's hard to, it's really hard to blame the receiver, the punt receiver, because, you know, he had a fair catch, he was clean, dropped the ball, and it looks like the Bisons are on the verge of squandering this opportunity.
Timeouts come to an end. Vipers wanting to discuss what they wanted to do with this, on this defensive play right here. Long third down, Harris will get 5 free yards because the Vipers decide to get inside the neutral zone. So third and 13 will become third and 8. Harris looking to throw after the penalty. Has a man off the fingertips. That was just a well-timed hit there by the Vipers. Number one, just – no, that's the look like number one from up here. I can't quite see it.
Trevor Dell Jr. incomplete.
Oh, excuse me, that was number five. A.J. Dillard again breaking that pass up.
Third down, seven.
So the new players on the field, including, let's see, we said number 80 was – oh, field goal attempt.
Yeah, field goal attempt.
Love it.
Trevor Spaulding going to test it out the leg here. He'll be attempting a 41-yard field goal attempt.
This will be about
fourth and seven.
40-yard field goal.
And line and drive kick up. Goes far left. No good. No good. So the Bison can't extend the lead, but there's a flag that comes in very late after the play. Looked like Trevor Spaulding was down on the turf, so it may be – it'll all depend on if we'll have the – just running into the kicker or if we'll have Nope, they pick up the flag, so no flag on the play. Field goal's missed, so the score remains the same. Bison 7, Viper 6, 6:26 left to go here in the ball, or excuse me, in the first quarter.
Well, I got to say, I loved that they took the shot. I really do, too.
And one of the things that kind of I think is interesting about this ball game is that we're seeing the Bison last week had a low-scoring affair against the Tigers, and yeah. That was kind of surprising for us because you know, this is such a – I mean, we put a lot of points on the board. We have a really good offense. So to see the Bison, it seems like they may be carrying over some struggles from last week and being able to get this offense going.
6:26 to go in the first quarter. Still the early stages of this very important football game tonight. Possible playoff seeding being decided here, possibly also the end of the season for the Vipers.
So after the missed field goal attempt, the Vipers' first play from scrimmage from their own 32-yard line is a huge catch.
He caught it.
Just shy of the 30-yard line. Actually, they are going to spot him at the 30. What a beautiful catch. And a huge new set of downs there for the Vipers. That looked like number 88 on the catch.
And you can see we're about to
Patrick Gamble
rolling the replay right now if you want to take a look at that once again.
I mean, Gamble just gets ahead of the defenders. That was just a beautifully thrown ball. Fantastic job by the Vipers. Got to give credit where credit is due. All the way up to the Bison 30-yard line.
And we go back to that pregame prep, you know,
right?
And said the Vipers didn't look like they were ready to play, and they certainly are.
Yeah, that's the last time that I say that a team didn't look like they came out ready, because they have definitely proved that they're ready to play some football.
Well, you know, back in school, I got my best test scores when I actually didn't study.
Well, so there's something to be said right now that, ooh, we do have an injured Viper on the field around the 20-yard line, far side. Can't get a number on him, but hopefully this Viper will be okay.
Now, while they tend to him, go ahead and invite you, everybody inside the booth, and talk a little bit about what we've seen so far. So far it's been pretty evenly matched game. We've had both teams have broken off big plays for touchdowns, maybe when they probably shouldn't have. We've seen a little bit of a letdown in the Bison's defense. That first touchdown would not have happened if the first tackle had been made. That's for sure. But they've come back ever since then and haven't let the Vipers get anything else.
That's true, but the Vipers have also found a way to return the favor because, of course, we scored on our first offensive drive. Fantastic job, but, I mean, 47-yard run by Love. But it's been – ever since those two initial touchdowns, both these teams' defenses have really tightened their belts a little bit. The offensive unit for our Bison, unfortunately, like I said, they're just playing a little flat right now. It seems like they're on their heels a little bit. The Vipers defense, I mean, they're doing a really good job of messing Harris up in the backfield.
Now, also, you heard me praising the Bison secondary earlier, but one thing I've noticed ever since then is the Vipers have gotten really good at getting that one receiver open at the far end, at the far side of the secondary.
Yeah, they have found a way. They're getting their speedster out there because he is getting past this defensive unit for the Bison. It's really impressive to watch the Vipers really square off against this defensive unit for the Bison. The Bison defense have been, honestly, I know this offensive unit is really good, but I've really loved watching this defensive unit go to work. And today they're struggling a little bit against the Vipers.
So the injured player is being helped off the field. It looks like we're about ready to get back to play. He's walking off under his own power now.
Vipers ball, first and 10 on the 20-yard line.
And as you can hear our PA announcer, first and 10 on the 20. Is this the same announcer we had last time?
I'm not sure, to be completely honest.
Man, that guy was so entertaining. Kept pushing the wings.
Yeah, he did like the wings a lot. So we'll keep our eye on the injured Viper. Hopefully he'll be able to make his way back out a little bit later. Here's the snap. The fake the handoff up the middle, find the corner of the end zone, and off the hands.
Incomplete, broken up by number.
Ken Blue defending that pass, did a pretty good job, but that was more on the Viper receiver than anything. His hands were, he was pretty clear of that catch, and it just popped right off his hands. So the Vipers missed opportunity to put more points on the board and take the lead back against our Bison. The Bison are very thankful that that pass fell incomplete. First and 10 becomes second and 10 after the incomplete pass. And this time they hand the ball off. No, it fakes me out up here in the booth as well. Good job defending that one at the goal line.
Got a flag on the far side, though, right there at the 19.
Number 35, Thompson on the defense there. Gets in front of it.
And they just called offside on the defense.
So essentially a free play.
And 5 free yards.
Yep. So now we're looking at a 2nd and 5 instead of a 3rd and 10. Inside the red zone. And honestly, the first time the Vipers have been inside the red zone today, they got the first touchdown from 75 yards away. They didn't have to even get there.
from the other team's red zone.
Yeah, from the other team's red zone. And fakes the handoff again. Pass near side this time. And well defended. No flags thrown. Number 17, Kadarian Booker for the Bison. Get in there and breaks that one up. Brings up 3rd and 5. Vipers going to the air quite a bit tonight. They've only had three plays in this first quarter on the ground. Is right. 4 yards, 5 yards, and -2. So I think they're relying on the ground game at all today? I don't think so.
Not much, no.
Not so far anyway. 4 wide for the Vipers. Taylor hands it off. We talk about the ground game, and then they go to it. And you see the Bison working hard. You got to give credit where credit is due.
Yeah.
Marquise Taylor doing a phenomenal job just fighting there to get some yardage. And believe it or not, I think he got one. The whole time, Booker on his back fighting to get him off the, moving forward.
I mean, I saw no fewer than 6 Bisons get a hand on that guy, and it took almost all of them to bring him down.
So we are going to call it 4th and 4 up here in the booth. 1 yard on the ground by Taylor. Big 4th down play here for the Vipers as they've decided to keep their offensive unit on the field They need 4 yards for a first down. We'll see if we go for it. Oh, and yeah, the Taylor's going to hold on to it. The big quarterback Taylor rumbles forward, gets inside the 10, and gets taken down somewhere between the 5 and 7 yard line. So a new set of downs for the Vipers, first and goal.
Stop by number 15, Demetrius Moles.
They're going to officially mark him at the 8 yard line.
Good enough for a Vipers first down.
So for first and goal from the 8.
So okay. First and goal for the Vipers.
So after, you know, praising the Vipers air game, they're going to the ground game may be what puts the next score on the board for
it
them.
It could be, especially if Taylor's going to keep running the ball like that. Four wide receivers to the Vipers, and this time they hand it off. Ooh, big oh. Hit at the 5 yard line.
Get to about the 4 yard line.
Taylor was going nowhere on the ground.
We stopped by
that was Marquise
15,
Taylor, by the way, number 34, the running back for the Vipers. Did you get the number of the truck that ran him over at the 5 yard line for the Bison?
No, I did not.
Because that was a hit. That was a beautiful, beautiful hit. It's looking at second and goal now. A couple of yards gained on that one.
Taylor passes up and it's complete.
And in the back of the end zone, the Vipers find a way to score again through the air.
Making your score now 12-7.
Yeah, I'm trying to get the number of that Viper that got the touchdown. It looks like number 7. If that's the case, that was Devontae Cobbs on the catch. 12-7 the score now. Vipers on top of the Bison. Extra point try. Oh, actually, it looks like we might be going for a two-point conversion. Vipers keeping their offensive unit out there. Yeah, the Vipers are going to go for the two-point conversion here, try to make this a 14-7 ball game. Bison defense setting up big and almost breaks it up but can't get it done. The two-point conversion is good. The Vipers make this a 14-7 ball game with 1:26 left to go here in the first quarter. And the defense is here. It really feels like that's what's going to be a battle of. See which one's bend at the line of scrimmage the most.
Yeah, I mean, the air battle was looking good for a while, but now, of course, it's nice to see a multifaceted game. You know, a one-dimensional game gets boring.
That's true.
It really does.
It really, really does.
It doesn't really make for good television. And, you know, I also like to see a close game between a couple of evenly matched opponents because, you know, a beatdown doesn't make for good television either, unless you're an absolute home team homer.
Well, the Vipers are able to knock off about 6.5 minutes or 5.5 minutes, excuse me, off the clock on that offensive drive. Only one penalty that went against our Bison, which gave up 5 yards. But that ultimately set up because of that big first play from scrimmage. 25 or so catch for number 88, Patrick Gamble, for the Vipers that set up the rest of that offensive drive. So. Now the Bison are out on the field looking to return this one. Love back deep. The ball bounces at the 20, scooped up by Love up to the 30, 35, and a blocker in front of him unfortunately gets in the way. So Love will go down at the 39-yard line. Still decent field position for the Bison to get this one started. 1:19 left here in the first quarter. And it looks like they're actually going to spot him at the 40. So 20-yard return there by Love.
Works for me.
Harris struggling in the backfield for our Bison here today a little bit. The Vipers are getting a lot of penetration. So we'll see how this offensive line adjusts a little bit. Looks like we've got a couple of tight ends out there now to stack that line up. Handoff, far side, new running back in the game for the Bison. Speedster, number 5.
Right side to number 5.
Alvin Smith is going to get about 6 yards on that carry, bringing up a second and four.
Currently Navarro High School, formerly Lanier High School, here in the Austin area.
Second and four now for the Bison on their own 45-yard line. Again, the handoff and leaping over the 50-yard line after getting tripped up a little bit. Puts them in Viper territory after a great run. Needed four. And he got it and a whole lot more up to the 53. Or make that the 47, excuse me.
Man, Alvin Smith is a breath of fresh air in this offense.
And a flag comes in on this one. Harris looking to throw, and you can see the penetration by that Viper defense.
It's an illegal motion in the backfield, though, I think, in the Bison backfield.
Illegal procedure on the offense.
So that's going to – okay, first and 15.
Yep. Back them up five. And looking for – look at this nice little scamper. Gets him up to the 45-yard line. So we'll make up the negative yards and a few more. They'll officially spot – that was number 83.
And that's the end of the first quarter.
Trevor Dell Jr., the nice little catch and run. First quarter's come to an end. The Vipers hold the lead 14-7 over the Bison. We'll swap sides. And the Bison will continue this offensive drive, which honestly is looking pretty good right now, Kevin.
Yeah, and I'm really impressed with the performance of the new running back in the game, Alvin Smith. I mean, he's not anybody – I mean, obviously you and I haven't been here for every game of the season, but it's not somebody I recall seeing in our previous couple of broadcasts.
He's seen some – he's been in relief duty like this for Love, but he actually – we saw him a couple weeks ago, if you remember, when Love went down.
When he was
down,
yeah.
We definitely saw him then, and he did a really good job. There was a trio of them that helped out after Love got hurt. So we'll see if they keep Smith in there, because he is definitely – his elusiveness has definitely opened up a different avenue for the running game here for the Bison.
Elusiveness, that's one good word. Also, he's got some really good power. He's got some really good speed. When I say power, it doesn't appear to be like not in the straight ahead run you over sense, but in the catch me if you can sense.
Yeah, exactly. Start calling the purple streak.
I like it. I want to say once again to our cameraman for the night, Dakari Gregory. Doing an excellent work. Stepped up at the last second to help us out. Couldn't be more grateful to you tonight, Dakari.
Second and six for the Bison. 15 minutes on the clock to start the second quarter. And on the Viper 47, and a good run again by Smith. Again, nothing super flashy, but he's very effective, getting another three or four yards on the ground.
Is that going to leave us third and four? Okay, got it. Lost track when they switched stands, so.
So crediting with 2 yards on that last carry for this third and four. Trip wide receivers here near side. Harris not liking the look of this defense. What happens? Harris with a quick throw, caught just at the first down marker, maybe a yard past it. Phenomenal job. There is Perry again. Second time he's been targeted here today. Very, very shifty wide receiver. Now up to the Viper 36. New set of downs. Snap back to Harris, the run. Oh, the ball is on the turf, and the Vipers recover it at their own 34-yard line.
the cover by the Vipers.
Alvin Smith unfortunately coughs it up and gives the Vipers another opportunity. And this offensive drive was looking really good for our Bison.
That's number five, Alvin Smith, slow to get up.
Even this early in the game, that's really not something you can afford to do, especially when you're already down by seven.
That would have been very close to a first down for Smith if he had been able to hold on to that football. Unfortunately.
Also, Smith looks like he's in a little bit of pain as he comes off the field. Like he took a pretty good shot to the gut on that last tackle.
So the Bison have the ball for about 3 minutes before coughing it up. And now the Vipers will take over with 13:32 left to go here in the first half from their own 33-yard line, first and 10. Terrence Taylor with the snap, hands it off, and the Bison are there, and the ball is out. Vipers able to recover it back at the line of scrimmage. There were two purple jerseys in the territory, but unfortunately they couldn't get there in time. Patrick Gamble with the heads-up play for the Vipers, recover the fumble, and now, and it looks like they're going to give Gamble a yard, so first and 10 becomes second and 9. .1302 and counting on the clock here in the first half. Give you the standings here at the halftime. We've got the BSFL standings for you folks, so you can get a kind of a picture of what the playoffs might be looking like. There's a lot of teams out there with a lot of 7 and 8 and 9 win seasons in front of us, so there's going to be playoffs are going to be very, very interesting once we get there. Nice run there by the Vipers that chipped away at that field a little bit, bringing up a second and 4. Make that a, they're showing 3rd and 4 on the scoreboard, 2nd and 4 by the chain gang, so I'm not sure who to trust. Should be 3rd and 4.
There we go. Is the official on the far sideline there at the 40 to say, yeah, man, flip that.
3rd down and 4.
12 minutes on the clock, and the Bison jump, but able to get back before the snap. Terrence Taylor looking things down one more time.
He better be. They're coming for him.
Snap, and the handoff again.
Oh.
The Vipers just a yard past the first down marker, which is all they need. Actually, they just need an inch past that first down marker, but still a new set of downs for the Vipers. 3rd and 4 becomes 1st and 10.
Technically a millimeter to it.
Yeah, that's right. So another 5-yard run by the Vipers brings up 1st and 10. And now they're set up at their own 44-yard line. Vipers are really leaning on the ground game a lot here. Three plays in a row on the ground. Of course, technically the first one was a fumble that was recovered for a 1-yard gain, but
1st and 10, Vipers.
Taylor with the snap, looking to throw. Far side has his running back out of the backfield. Hurdles over one purple jersey and finally gets taken down from behind at the 45-yard line. That'll be good for a new set of downs on an 11-yard reception. So now to the Bison 45, 1st and 10 for the Vipers. Vipers again showing 4 wide. Taylor with the snap, brings it in, another ground, or another run. That one's going to be good for a 7-yard gain by the Vipers. Suddenly, they are finding a lane in the ground game.
And they're finding it on this near side, or the right side, rather, of the defensive line. I'm going to take a closer look at the blocking scheme this time and see what's going on in there.
You can see a little bit of the body language as some of the players come off the field.
A little frustrated.
Justice Thomas. Excuse me, Kalen Bright coming off the field just now for the Bison. Letting his sideline know we need to get things together. 9:19 left to go on the clock and counting. Vipers looking at a second and three. And a little pitch out to the running back. And with some room, flag on the play, bounces it inside and finally gets hit. Drives forward with a second effort. The whistle blows this one at the 24-yard line, but it'll be enough for a first down pending the penalty.
Pending the penalty.
Number 17
Peter
on the
Piper
stop.
Pick. No, never.
That's Kadarian Brooker.
Let's see where we're going to wind up.
It's going to be a holding call going against the Vipers, so the big first down run will be negated. Mark 10 yards off from the spot of the foul. And we will still be looking at a second down.
Second and
should be, yeah, depends on where they spot the foul at. Looks like they're marking it about 2 yards shy of the first.
So that would give us second and 12.
Second and 12, yes, sir. Just a little windy out there as the cold front's trying to blow through here, the Central Texas area. Got rain in the forecast, anywhere from 2 to 4 inches over the next 5 to 7 days. We'll see if it happens because we desperately need it. But we'll take the rain, just no lightning or thunder here so we can keep this game going.
Your second quarter weather forecast brought to you by the McAdams Company LLC, professional live stream producers. If you like what you see, give us a call.
Right? I like it. Second and 12 after the penalty for the Vipers. And Taylor looking to throw far side, has a man but can't find him. Overthrows the defender and the wide receiver.
And actually, current radar shows thunderstorms to our north in the Waco area.
Bring up third down.
And out to the southwest, hanging around Bernie and Kerrville.
Second and 12 becomes third and 12 after the incomplete pass. We also stopped the clock at 8:53. The Vipers holding on to this one so far for right at 4 minutes. And that is really the kind of, in my opinion, the story of this ball game is when the Vipers get a hold of this football, they hold on to it for a long time. And
a lot of clock.
Yeah. And when you're down by a possession, you've got to find a way to get this football out of the Vipers' hands. Third and 12. Taylor with the snap, and he's in trouble, steps up in the pocket, finally gets rid of it and gets hit as he throws. Ball bounces off the turf at the 25, right into the hands of number two, Devonta Jones. Incomplete pass brings up fourth and 12. Great job by that defense to get the penetration, get in Taylor's face. Do not let him get comfortable and throw a bad pass, and he threw a bad pass because of it.
Well, and now the worm has kind of turned. We saw the Bisons in this same situation late in the first quarter down at the other end of the field.
Looks like they do have the punting unit out on the field for the Vipers. So we'll see them work for the first time tonight. So the punt for the Vipers all the way back at the 40-yard line. High end-over-end punt hits the turf at the 13 and takes a Viper bounce. Can't keep it out of the end zone, though.
Into the end zone for a touchback.
So a touchback for the Vipers, for our Bison. We'll set this one up on the 25-yard line. 8:39 left to go here in the first half. And the Vipers just really holding on to that football. We talked about it earlier, Kevin. They just don't let it go.
No, they do not.
They eat the clock up. And right now they have that one possession lead. And we still have a whole half of football. I know we have a lot of football left to play, but the way this is going, I think we might want to play with a little more urgency. Not only that, we just got to find get our feet underneath us. The offense is, I mean, we had a really good drive going there from that last offensive drive, but that and the first one have really been the highlight of the game so far. We need to find our rhythm a little bit more on offense. Three wide for the Bison. Harrison Love in the backfield. And in trouble, dumps it and gets rid of it. Harrison puts it at the feet of Love.
Intended for number 41, Eric Love, incomplete.
So the first and 10 pass.
Second down.
We'll go for no yards at all. Trying to get it to Love. I think it was more of those, just get the ball close to a receiver so he didn't get in trouble for intentional grounding. Two white jerseys all in his face. Second and 10 for our Bison, four wide receivers. Big number 8 out on the field. We saw him 2 weeks ago. Set up for the screen. Harris steps up in the pocket, finally lets it go, and out of the hands of number 83. Trevor Dell Jr. just couldn't bring it in. Wide open and had the first down. Probably would have had 5, even maybe 10 more yards after the catch.
Yeah, he had a room to run, out to the far side and then take a right turn. Not sure if he'd get all the way to the goal line, but he would, like you said, at least another 10-15.
Yeah, he could have eaten up some yardage for sure. Number 6, Jamari Perry comes out on the field. Caught a couple of big passes here so far in this game. Very pivotal first down catch in the last catch he made. Empty backfield for Harris. I'm going to watch for the screenplay here, Kevin. I think it's a good spot for it. We'll see what happens. Oh, the Vipers may be offsides. There's the flag. Free play. And it won't matter.
Well, it's a good thing because that was picked off, but that is not going to count.
Yeah, incomplete. No play on that one.
Flag on the play.
Vipers jump into the neutral zone. So a 5-yard penalty will make this 3rd and 10 a 3rd and 5.
There's indications offsides on the defense.
Trevor Dell Jr. comes off the field.
Still Vipers ball. Correction, still Bison
and
ball.
Thankfully for Harris, thanks to that penalty, he doesn't get an INT on his record tonight. At least not yet.
Driver comes out in the spot where Dell was. Empty backfield again for Harris. See if the offensive line can hold. Quick pass caught at the 30. That'll be good for a first down. Second effort up to the 32. So great job by the new
driver
getting the job done, getting his number called. He's going to come off the field, though, a little gimpy. Did his job, though, got his team a first down on a 7-yard catch. Vipers set up, Bison set up on their own 32-yard line now.
First and 10, Bison.
Ooh, a little extra movement there, a little by the Vipers.
All over the field.
Oh, your favorite comment.
Laundry.
Your favorite. Laundry, you love that.
Illegal use of a Maytag.
So Vipers will give us 5 more yards, and we'll take them. Second and 5 now for our Bison.
You give him 5. Maybe you give him 6 to me. Okay, there. Dude holding the down marker, man. Hey, get that man a cup of coffee off the food truck or something.
Harris with the snap. Hands it back to Love. Love's got a lane, and he uses it. Oh, hit and bounced off. Up at the 45, cuts it back across the field. Now he's up to the 40. It gets shoved and finally stumbles out of bounds, but not before he gets inside the 25-yard line. Make that the 30-yard line.
Oh, yeah, we are totally going to watch that again.
That was a phenomenal run by Love.
Here's a snap. Love gets held up right there on the left side of the line, and then he bounces out, turns around to his right, and busts it loose for another 20 yards or so. Man.
That is a 27-yard run for Love.
Kari, can you get the camera on the play, please? Thank you.
First and 10
Bison. For our Bison on the Viper 37 after that big run by Love. Love comes off the field for a little breather, well-deserved as well. And the snap back to Harris, has some good protection. The throw is caught at the 21-yard line. And still on his feet, trying to make something happen. Hit at the 15 and gets shoved down to the turf. The ball is loose. Is that Garner?
The ball is still alive.
No whistle as of yet. And finally, the Bison hold on to the great. If that was, I think that was Garner number 8. It sure was. Garner was there to get scoop that ball off the turf. The big tight end helping out his offense in every way he can. Phenomenal job. Ugh. That was a 16, ultimately ended up being a 16-yard pass for a new set of downs. At the Viper, make that 14-yard line. Five and a half minutes left to go here in the first half, and the Bison at least want to try to tie this up before we go to halftime.
Bison, first and goal.
Harris fakes the handoff, has some man downfield inside that corner.
Got it.
Caught! The Viper, excuse me, yeah, the Bison can't be stopped as Connor Kokin out of Lake Travis High School gets his first catch of the night and a touchdown to go with it. 1 point away from tying things up. 5:11 left to go here in the first half. Vipers 14, Bison 13. Extra point try coming up. We talked about how this offense needed to come out on this drive, really get things going,
yeah.
And that's exactly what they did. Two penalties by the Vipers did help out. They gave them 10 yards on the with being inside the neutral zone. The extra point is up and good. The Bison tie things up 14 apiece with 5:11 left to go here in the first half. And this really was a phenomenal drive. Started at our own 25-yard line, goes 75 yards in just over 3 minutes. You can't ask for a better offensive drive than that.
No, you cannot. I mean, that's pretty much textbook of how it's supposed to be done. And with 5 minutes, 11 seconds still to go, if the defense comes out and does what they're capable of, we know they're capable of, the Bisons can still get one more possession this half and go into the into the locker room ahead.
I'll tell you right now, the Vipers defensive coach is mad as heck because this is how this drive started for us.
Okay.
On our own 25, we went first and 10. No, we went, didn't get anything. Second and 10, didn't get anything. Third and 10, the Vipers give us 5 yards on a penalty, on the defensive penalty. Third and 5, we get a 7-yard pass to set up the rest of that drive. So if the Vipers would not have gotten the 5-yard penalty, shoulda, coulda, woulda, this could have been a different drive completely for our Bison.
Yeah, I mean, if not for that one offside penalty, it's an interception, and the drive ends, and this could have been 21-7 Vipers right now.
Yeah, it absolutely could be. The Bison.
But, you know, credit the Bison for proper use of a gift horse.
Exactly. Spalding out there to kick the ball away to the Vipers. And Spalding puts a boot into it. It's a high end over end kick. Returnable, bounces at the 10, scooped up at the 10, up to the 25, 30, finally gets hit and taken down at the 34-yard line, 33-yard line. That was a phenomenal hit.
4-yard line where the Vipers will take over first and 10.
So big return there, all the way up to the 34. So a 24-yard return by the Vipers.
And Bison still have all three timeouts for the first half. The Vipers have two.
Yep.
Wondering if we'll see all of those get used here in the next 4 minutes and 59 seconds.
I think this first, these first three plays will determine what the Bison do with these timeouts. I really do think that. If they can stop this Viper offense and at least force them into a fourth and long, mm-hmm. we're going to see a timeout come up real quick. That wasn't lightning. Did I just see lightning?
It's possible.
I thought I saw it off over here. I hope not.
So I was checking.
There's the snap. And hit in the backfield, able to get a yard out of it, and then driven backwards. So first and 10 becomes second and 9 with 4:50 left to go here in the first half.
Well, I was checking the weather radar just a few minutes ago, and it does show some thunderstorm activity to the north of here. Of course, we're in Round Rock at the northern end of the Austin metro area.
4.5 minutes left to go here in the first half.
So some lightning out to the northeast. But, yeah, and we'll definitely have to keep an eye on that. As everybody watching this knows that lightning is about the only thing that can shut down a football game in Texas.
Absolutely true. New quarterback in for the Vipers as well, as I just caught it. Catch, no pun intended, as the catch is made at the 40-yard line by the Vipers. The ball is out. Great job by the Bison to strip that one loose. That was number 17. Kadarian Booker gets his hand in there, rips the ball out, but unfortunately can't secure it. It goes out of bounds.
Yeah.
Still be a first down for the Vipers. Holy cow, what a great job, though.
Vipers first down.
It's going to be good for about 12 yards through the air. First and 10, up to the Viper 48-yard line. Three and a half minutes left to go here in the first half, and I think the Bison are going to be, after that, that's just when you'll see, they're going to let the clock run. Let's see what happens here. 3:20 left to go here in the first half. Four wide for the Bison, or excuse me, the Vipers, and it's going to be a run play. Big running back in on the ground for the Vipers. That's number 22, Kevin Best. He's going to be good for about five on the ground. So second and 5 now for the Vipers.
3 yards on the play, bring up second down and about 6.
It also puts them on the Bison 47-yard line. Clock still running, 2:40 and counting. Vipers using up all the play clock here on this drive. Four wide, three at the top. And fakes the handoff. Throw near side, has a man off the fingertips.
Oh.
No good, incomplete pass. The new quarterback in for the Vipers is Juan Cabral, yeah. Second and 5 becomes third and 5 after the incomplete pass. Clock stops at 2:16.
Third down and 6.
Big third down play here for the Bison defense. We will be creeping up on that 2-minute warning. Don't know if this play will go 16 seconds, but we'll see what happens. The snap back to Cabrala, and the ball off the fingertips, of the intended wide receiver. Can't see the number from here, but there's also three purple jerseys in the neighborhood. It looks like number 3, Isaiah Garcia, just wasn't able to come up with that catch. And now looking at a 4th and 6, it looks like the Vipers are going to punt this ball away again. Clock stopped at 2:11. I think it's smart football.
I don't know if I would at this point or not.
If you're the Vipers, you've watched the Bison team. They've been able to move the football, but they haven't been able to move the football extremely fast. So I think they're thinking with 2:11. I mean, granted, we haven't seen two-minute drill yet either. Yeah. So we'll see what happens. They're bringing it, trying to block this punt, almost get it done. Hits at the 9, and I'll take a Viper bounce out of the back of the end zone. So with 2:11 left on the clock,
all the way in the end zone for a touchback.
The Bison will have an opportunity here.
Well, okay, so the smart money was on your side that time because they at least the Bison have the ball, but at least they're pinned, you know, way back in their own
deep.
Side.
Yeah. First and 10 for the Bison, though, 2:11. Lots of 2:08, actually. They have it marked on the clock.
And, you know, maybe with a couple of – with two incomplete passes on that drive, maybe they didn't have a lot of faith in Cabral to – you know, to complete on for 4th and 6.
Yeah, that's true. I mean, they did a good job. He did a good job. He knocked off just over 3 minutes off the clock.
Yeah.
So he did what he needed to do is in the aspect of trying to eat up as much clock since the Bison didn't have that much to work with before halftime. But I think they're underestimating how fast this offense can move at the same time. I think the Vipers are going to be a little shocked here on this offensive drive. Harris looking to throw, has a man on the quick. That's going to be Love. Love will be credited with 3 on that one. Actually, it looks like 2.
And we just hit the 2-minute warning, so everybody will get a breather.
We'll have 2nd and 8 after the 2-minute warning.
2nd down, about 8.
I kind of like that little play. You know you're going to get the 2-minute warning, but Love has that ability that on that little screen pass,
right.
He could break that loose. He could have ran down the field, and we could be looking at, you know, 1:40 left on the clock and another score on the board. So I kind of like that first play from scrimmage to get things started right before this halftime break. We'll take a look at the Big Southern standings from around the area, all the way from the Valley region to the Bayou City division. So we will kind of get an idea of what the playoffs may be looking like. But as I've mentioned a couple times in this broadcast, there are a lot of teams that have won a lot of games. So this is it's going to shake up pretty interesting. We'll see, especially over the next week or two, when we still have some finals, you know, regular season games to play. Of course, our Bison will be on the road for their final game of the season, this being their final home game. We are very happy to have worked with the Bison this season. We hope you guys have enjoyed the broadcast. Reach out to the Bison. Let them know what you think, good and bad. And reach out to us. Let Kevin know how we are doing and what we could do to make these broadcasts better. We would love the feedback.
Can private message me through Facebook or email Kevin at themcadamscompany.com.
And the pass play here for Harris, who's in trouble, and he's going to get dropped all the way back at the 7-yard line. Big sack by the Vipers. We were looking at a 2nd and 8 from the 22-yard line, and now we are looking at a 3rd and 20 from the 10. So that was a 12-yard loss on the sack.
About a minute and a half, and I think we've got timeout.
I believe the Vipers have taken their first time or yeah.
Second timeout.
Second timeout.
Bisons have yet to take one.
Oh, yeah. Well, is it the Bison? I don't know who took that timeout, to be completely honest.
No, ref credited it with credited for the Vipers.
Oh, okay.
Oh, wait. Now they're...
I don't know. All I know is we have 1:24 left on the clock to end the half, and we have 3rd and 1:83 and 35 exchange to get a first down. So,
wasn't an official timeout? I mean, I know the officials are all talking.
Yeah, I'm not sure, to be honest. By the way, both teams getting a little bit of a breather here, tied up at 14 apiece. And if you look at the standings, you kind of wouldn't expect this between these two teams. The Cap City Bison sitting at 7-1 on the season. The Vipers sitting at 3-5 right now. So kind of a shock right now for, I think, the Bison are looking at this game and kind of scratching their heads wondering what they need to change.
I mean, if you look at this on paper, you don't expect this to be 14-14 as we head for the second half.
All right, timeout's come to an end. We got a big third down play here for the Bison. Four wide receivers, Love in the backfield. Stays back in the backfield to block. Harris throws it and caught at the 24-yard line, almost to the first down marker. That is Garner on the catch. The big man comes through again for this offense.
Pass complete to number 8.
He is just 2 yards shy of the first down on the 18-yard completion. Fourth and 2 for the Bison. 1 minute left on the clock, and we're going for it. Harris looks to throw again and has his man caught at the 33, and the ball is out. The Vipers have recovered it.
No whistle yet.
No whistle. The Vipers could do a pick six here, or a scoop and score, I should say. Finally, the whistle's blown. Vipers run it out at the 10-yard line. 43 seconds left on the clock, and right now the Bison are trying to – we're all trying to figure out what just happened. I think they're going to try to figure it out as well. The officials are going to get together.
We'll take a look. You can see the fumble there. Let me wind that back a little bit more.
The Bison, I think player was down. But right now they're talking it over to make sure they get it right.
Just looking to get this queued up here.
Here we go.
So here we go. Wait, I think I went back too far. That's showing second down.
Well, it looks like we are going to have a change of the guard here. The defense looks like they are coming out on the field for our Bison.
Sorry about that. I thought I had that queued up properly.
That's all right. The officials just made it easy for us. They talked it over, and the Bison, unfortunately, do cough up the football. And with just 43 seconds left to go in this first half, the Vipers are inside the red zone.
If the Vipers score off of that, that's a game changer.
That's huge.
That's going to put the momentum all on their side going into halftime. And you can bet there will be a discussion of that play in the locker room.
From the Bison 12-yard line, first and goal for the Vipers. And a quick pass, trying to find it, and a little miscommunication, looking for the back corner of the end zone. Cabral, a little miscommunication with his wide receiver. Stops the clock the clock barely even, I don't think even ticked off. Any time at all. 43 seconds still on the clock. I think we should have lost at least a second or two there.
Second down and 10 for the Vipers.
So second and 10 for the Vipers. Still 43 seconds. Cabral with the snap. Fakes the handoff. Quick throw in and out of the hands because of a great defensive job there. Thompson gets his hand in there and breaks that pass up.
That's Ken Blue.
Fantastic job by the Bison. Third and 10 coming up for the Vipers. Two plays for 0 yards. Only 37 seconds left to go in this first half.
Down 10.
Four wide for Cabral. There's the snap. He's in trouble. Throws it near side. It's caught at the 6 and dives forward to about the 5. They're going to spot him at about the 4.5.
Which is going to give us 4th and 3.
4th and 3, yeah.
And the clock runs down past 20 seconds.
No timeouts called. 9 seconds left on the game clock. And now we have a timeout with 6 seconds. Timeout taken by the Vipers. So that will be, they show two left on the scoreboard, so we'll assume they have one left unless that was the last one.
Yeah, I got a little confused earlier too.
So a big defensive stand here for the Bison is essential. Vipers trying to extend this lead. This would be a huge momentum boost going into halftime after one recovering the fumble inside the red zone and two getting some points off of it. I'm wondering what the Vipers are thinking. Are they thinking, we've got 6 seconds left. Do we want to go for the score, or do we want to get their field goal unit out there and just extend the lead? So, or take the lead back, I should say. So the decision by the Vipers here is really more important than what's done by the Bison. All they have to do is keep them out of the end zone, regardless of what they're doing.
Right. Now, Bison still have all three of their timeouts. So when they come back out, do you call one just to ice them?
If they're coming out in the field goal formation, absolutely.
Yeah.
You might as well. Timeout's coming to an end. Defensive unit still staying on the field, although they are staying a little close to the sideline. I think they're trying to be able to switch out pretty quickly with their special teams unit if they need to. And it looks like the offensive unit will stay out on the field. No, I take that back. It is the field goal unit. So the Vipers will send out the special teams unit to try to hit this 3 points. No, they brought in a different quarterback. That's what's going on. They brought Taylor back into the game. So Cabral is off. Taylor's back on. Three wide. We got a big fullback in the backfield. Look for the refrigerator here. Look for that Steve Perry play. Or Tyler. And there it was. And they tried to fake out the Bison. The Bison weren't having it. The defense shut them down. Turnover on downs. And the Bison still with 2 seconds to do something.
Huh. Well, even if they can't do anything with this 2 seconds, this stop was absolutely necessary.
Absolutely.
And phenomenal.
Yes, and phenomenal, but absolutely necessary. So 2 seconds left to go here in the first half. Bison will get to decide what they want to do with those 2 seconds, whether it be a run a play or just take a knee and go into halftime. I think right now, honestly, if I'm the Bison, I would be happy with the knee. You got some momentum off that big stop by the defense.
Yeah.
I don't see a reason why, risking anyone or an injury here, but at the same time,
throw a Hail Mary, risk a Music City Miracle.
Yeah, maybe, because the Vipers have shown their, that was lightning. I'm pretty sure I saw lightning. But, the Vipers have shown they've come here to play. Regardless of what their pregame ceremonies are, they came to play some football today.
And the play we've seen in this first half is not reflected in their record.
No, it really isn't. It really, really isn't. So I believe we were going to have a delay of game penalty go against the Bison, excuse me. Couldn't get all the right personnel out there in time to get things going. So, or did we call a timeout in time? Yeah, it looks like we called out a time. I called a timeout just in time. That'll leave us 2 seconds left to go on the clock as well as two timeouts. The coach calling the timeout to get all the personnel he needed out there to avoid the delay of game. We'll talk about the standings throughout the league, and we will also, of course, the Bison cheerleaders are here. We'll probably put on a show. We want to make sure you guys catch that. We won't want to miss out on any of the sights and sounds of the game if we can afford it. Oh, that was definitely lightning. Well, hopefully we'll keep keep the game going. And there's the knee. 2 seconds to wind off the clock, and we'll go into halftime with a tied ball game. Bison 14, Vipers 14. Don't go anywhere, Bison fans. We're just going to silence the microphones, let you guys enjoy the Bison cheerleaders, and then we'll come back and break down the first half, talk about the keys to victory for the second half, as well as talk about the standings and playoff potentials right here on whatever, Bison broadcast, whatever this is.
You're watching Capital City Bison's football.
Enjoyment, please give it up for the Capital City Bison cheerleaders. Ladies and gentlemen, this is the inaugural season for the Bison cheerleaders, and we would like to thank them for their support and dedication to the Capital City Bison's program. Introducing our captain, Capital City Bison cheerleaders, Shelby, Andy, Michelle, Runaway Baby,
ladies and gentlemen, your Capital City cheerleaders.